This is Janet Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this problem, we are going to compare the angular frequency and the mechanical energy of two undamped elastic pendulums. Determine the initial phase angle of the second pendulum. Study the damped oscillations of the first pendulum.
Consider two horizontal elastic pendulums A and B. Pendulum A consists of a spring of force constant K1 and a block B1 of mass M1, while pendulum B consists of a spring of force constant K2 and a block B2 of mass M2. Neglect all the friction. Given the time equation for a simple harmonic motion is x equal xm sine omega 0 t plus phi, where xm is the amplitude of the oscillation, omega 0 is the angular frequency, and phi is the initial phase angle. The left graph represents the abscissa of the center of mass of B1 as a function of time, while the second graph represents the abscissa of the center of mass of B2 as a function of time. Question 1a. Use document A, or the left graph, to determine the amplitude xm1, the angular frequency omega 0,1 of the center of mass of B1. The left graph shows that the maximum value attained by the abscissa x is equal to 5 cm. Then the amplitude of pendulum A is equal to 5 cm. Now, to determine the angular frequency, we have to determine the natural period because it can be given directly from the graph. As you see, x starts with the value of minus 5 cm and then it increases to become 5 cm and then it decreases to become minus 5 cm after a time of interval of 1.4 seconds. So, the natural period of oscillation of pendulum A is equal to 1.4 seconds. So, the angular frequency omega 0,1 is given by 2 pi over the natural period, which is t0,1. So, substitute for t0,1, which is equal to 1.4 seconds. Therefore, the angular frequency of the center of mass of B1 is equal to 4.49 radians per second.
Let's move to part 1b. Determine the amplitude xm2, the angular frequency omega 0,2, and the initial phase angle phi 2 of the oscillations of the center of mass of B2. Let's start with the amplitude. As you see in the curve, the amplitude is 5 centimeters. Now let's move to the natural period. As you see, we have one oscillation, two oscillations, three and four oscillations extending over 6 seconds. So 4t02 is equal to 6 seconds, and the natural period is 6/4, which is equal to 1.5 seconds. Now let's move to the natural angular frequency. Omega 0,2 is equal to 2 pi over t02, which is equal to 2 pi over 1.5, and the answer is 4.19 radians per second. Now let's move to the initial phase angle phi. But first, we must specify from the curve the initial conditions, x0 and v0. So let's start with x0. x0 is the abscissa at t0 equals 0, which is 0 on the curve. Now let's determine v0. If you examine the curve, you see that we can't determine V0, but we just specify its direction. So the first method, examine the figure during the first quarter of the oscillation, x is decreasing, and then the center of mass of the block is moving in the negative x direction, and so V0 is negative. Now another method, you know that V is equal to x prime, so V0 is equal to the slope of the tangent to the curve x at t0 equals 0. So if this slope is negative, then V0 is negative, and if it is positive, V0 is positive. So look at the tangent to the curve at zero equals zero. The slope of this tangent is negative, and then V0 is negative. Now we are ready to determine the value of phi. So we have the initial conditions at t0 equals 0, x0 is equal to 0, and v0 is negative. And also we have the time equation x is equal to xm sine omega 0 t plus phi. Now you know to determine the value of phi, we need to substitute x0 into the expression of x and v0 into the expression of v. Let's start with x. So replace x by 0 and t by 0. This is going to be 0 is equal to xm sine phi. You know, omega 0 t now is 0. But xm is different from 0, so sine phi is equal to 0. Now, if sine phi is equal to 0, then the first value of phi is 0. But what is the second value? The second value is pi minus 0, which is equal to pi. The determination of phi is discussed in a video whose title is Initial Phase Angle in a Simple Harmonic Motion. So you can watch it. Now, we have two values of phi, 0 and pi radian. Now, which value is the correct value? Let's move to the expression of V. V is equal to x prime, which is equal to omega 0 x and cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Again, replace V by V0 and T by 0. This is going to be V0 is equal to omega 0 xm cosine phi. Now, omega 0 xm is a positive value and V0 is a negative value. So cosine phi is negative. Now, you have 0 and pi radians. Which one of these two angles has a negative cosine? You know that cosine 0 is positive. It is equal to 1. It is positive. But cosine pi is minus 1. So we will choose phi as pi radians.
Focus, please. This is important.
1C. Given that K1 is equal to K2. Part I, prove without calculation that M1 does not equal to M2. We use this formula. Omega 0 is equal to the square root of K over M. Then, omega 0 squared is equal to K over M, or M is equal to K over omega 0 squared. But K1 is equal to K2. And omega 01 does not equal to omega 02. Omega 01 is calculated in the previous bar slide, which is equal to 4.49, and omega 02 is equal to 4.19 radians per second. So we can conclude that M1 does not equal to M2. Part II. Proof without calculation that the mechanical energy of the system pendulum A Earth is equal to that of the system pendulum B Earth. We use the expression of the mechanical energy, which is equal to 1/2 mv squared plus 1/2 kx squared. But we know that when x is equal to xm, v is equal to 0, so the kinetic energy is also equal to 0. So the new expression of the mechanical energy is given by 1/2 kxm squared. But k1 is equal to k2, and xm1 is equal to xm2, which is equal to 5 cm as calculated in the previous slides. Therefore, me1 is equal to me2.
Now, let's study the damped oscillations of the first oscillator. In reality, the block B1 of pendulum A is subjected to a friction force. The curve represents the abscissa of the center of mass of the block B1 as a function of time. Given that the mechanical energy of the pendulum Earth system at T0 equals 0 is Me0, which is equal to 12.5 millijoules. Given that K1, the force constant of this spring is 10 newtons per meters and the natural period of this oscillator is 1.4 seconds. It is calculated in part 1a. Let's move to part 2a. The instant T1 has one of the following values, 1.35 seconds, 1.4 seconds, or 1.43 seconds. Specify which one. Now examine the figure. T1 is the time taken by one complete oscillation. So this time is the pseudo period of the oscillations. But you know that the pseudo period must be greater than the natural period. And our natural period is 1.4 seconds. So we must choose 1.43 seconds. So T1 is 1.43 seconds. Let's move to part 2b. Determine the thermal energy produced during the time interval 0 T1. Now let's first calculate the mechanical energy of the oscillator at T0 equals 0 and then at T1, and later we will calculate the thermal energy produced during this time interval. So let's start with the initial mechanical energy. The initial mechanical energy is equal to the initial elastic potential energy, because when x is equal to plus or minus x maximum, the speed is zero, so the kinetic energy is zero. So this is going to be 1/2 kx0 squared. K is 10 newtons per meter, and x0 is minus 5 centimeters, which becomes minus 0.05 meters. And the answer is 1.25 times 10 to the power minus 2 joules. Now let's move to the mechanical energy at T1. At this instant, the abscessa x is minus 3.3 centimeters. So similarly, the mechanical energy at T1 is equal to 1/2 kx at this instant squared. So 1/2 into 10, the force constant, 10 newtons per meters, and x is 3.3 centimeters, and then you divide it by 100, it becomes 0.033 meters, and the answer is 5.445 times 10 to the power minus 3 joules.
Then, the loss in the mechanical energy during the time interval 0 to 1 is given by ME0 minus ME at T equal to 1. So substitute for ME0, which is equal to 1.25 times 10 to the power minus 2, and ME at T equal to 1 is equal to 5.445 times 10 to the power minus 3. So the loss in the mechanical energy is equal to 7.055 times 10 to the power minus 3 joules. But we know that the work done by the friction force results in a transformation of mechanical energy into thermal energy. So the thermal energy produced is equal to that lost in the mechanical energy, which is equal to 7.055 times 10 to the power minus 3 joules. Part 2c. Knowing that the friction force acting on the oscillator is of the form of F equal minus HV, specify the magnitude of F at the instant T1. Look at the graph. At T1, x is equal to minus xm1, or we have a turning point. So at this instant, the speed of the block is equal to zero. So using the formula F equal minus HV, so F is equal to zero, and its magnitude is also equal to zero. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.